tell us one of the senses?
Taste.
Taste, okay. What can you taste?
Food.
Food, okay. What kind of food?
Macaroni.
Macaroni, right? Your favorite. And what kind of things can you touch?
Turkey.
You can touch turkey? Okay, yes you can. Yes, when you're eating it, yes.
You also touch the sand, water.
Yes, yes. Definitely. The beach, sand, and water, even in the sink. Excellent. We're also going to analyze. Analyze means to look at closely. Analyze and locate specific Caribbean islands on a map, okay? Right now, I'm going to show you all on the smart board a map of the Caribbean islands, and we're taking a field trip right now to the Caribbean. So if I have here from YouTube some Caribbean music I'm going to play for us for our lesson. One look at a map of the Caribbean islands. Alright, so have any of you, can somebody just looking at this map tell us a Caribbean island that they see?
Maybe.
Michael, can you come up and show us an island, please? Yes, excellent. Hey, oh, that's okay. Actually, that's fine. He tagged it, it went to another screen. I didn't know he was going to do that, but that's okay. Okay, the island of Haiti, okay? Do any of you know the major or official language of Haiti? I say I can't hear.
This is Spanish, right?
No, that's a good guess. Tara, what do you think Haitian people speak?
I want to try another island.
One moment, though. Amani, what language do the Haitian people speak? That's a good guess, but not Spanish. Okay, give me a hint. African is not a language, it's a nationality. Mr. Duguay, a teacher here, he's from Haiti. What does he speak? He speaks a lot of languages, but his main language is French. Haitian people speak French, okay? But there is some Spanish there too, because Haiti's next to another island.
Dominican Republic.
Yes, the people of the Dominican Republic speak what language mostly? Yes, so a lot of Haitians know Spanish, a lot of Dominicans know French. Very good. Amani, can you come up and show us another Caribbean island? Okay, yes, we know where the Dominican Republic is. Can you show us another one? Can you show us, yeah, we know where Haiti is. Can you show us another one? What's that called? Cuba, excellent. And we already know a lot about Cuba, don't we? Saran, can you tell us something you already know about Cuba? Yes, most of them do speak Spanish, and as you know, we also study the artwork this year.
It was related to China.
How?
Well, like, before one of them carts, the one with the horses and stuff on.
Oh, like a chariot or wagon?
Yeah, and okay. Like from other carts, the one that people carry and stuff.
Oh, the hand cart? Okay.
That's how it's related.
So you're saying Cuban people and Chinese people carry the same kind of carts in their countries? Okay, to transport people and goods?
But okay. Cuba has different houses, like, their houses are kind of made like part of rock. Like, it's built like they've been old, like,
okay, so older homes you believe in Cuba than in China. Alright. Michael, can you come up? You showed us an island already, I'm sorry. Isaiah, can you come find another island for us?
Okay.
Yes, what are they called?
Cayman Islands.
Yes, and these are called the Cayman Islands. Why do you think UK is underneath the Cayman Islands? Why do you think the United Kingdom would be underneath the Cayman Islands? That name. I'm not saying the United Kingdom, the country under the Cayman Islands, no. The United Kingdom includes places like Ireland, England. The Cayman Islands are owned by the United Kingdom, okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Just like we have the U.S. Virgin Islands, they're owned by the United States. That's why we're talking about the United States Virgin Islands. So isn't it amazing how these faraway countries own all these tiny little islands? But some islands are independent. Can you show us other islands that belong to the United Kingdom? Okay, we have, looks like Antigua and Barbuda. Okay. So, how would you guys feel if you could own an island? How would you feel? Amani, how would you feel if you could own an island? You would think it's good? Yes, excellent, right? Okay, have any of you ever been to the Caribbean Islands? No. Miss Mara, who's not here today, unfortunately, she's been to Jamaica many times. I went to Jamaica as well 5 years ago for my sister's wedding. Very beautiful. She got married on the beach. But guys, the reason I'm talking about the Caribbean today is because your book, we're going to find out the setting of our book, okay? Okay. I'm going to pause the music for now. Okay. I like Isaiah. Everyone's going to please turn your book over. You know, before we do that, before we look on the back of our books, Monty, close your book, please. Thank you. Monty, look in front of your book. Monty, thank you. The cat. Let's look carefully at the illustrations, the cover art. You have a book, Michael? If everyone's books are out, thank you. I want us to quietly analyze the artwork on the front of this book. Amani, what do you see? You see a boy? What is the boy doing? He's looking at the tree. And why might he be looking at this tree? Because it's brown? Okay, what else is the boy doing? He's doing what? Why is this little boy holding the tree? Because the tree is beautiful? Okay, possibly. So, Ryan, when you look at this drawing of this little boy holding the tree, well, first of all, guys, what kind of tree is this?
Palm tree.
Palm tree. Why do you think it's a palm tree? Okay, it might be an island setting, right? What kind of trees do we normally find in the Caribbean? Palm trees, correct, right? Because it's a tropical climate. Can anyone help Amani? Why do you think this boy is holding this palm tree so tightly?
Because there's like a flood going on, so, but I just noticed in the picture, like, he's tied, like, right on the tree, but the little man is not.
So you're saying the little boy's tired?
Tied.
Oh, it's
like tied. I'm talking about like tied.
Oh, yes. I just, wow. It does look like they're tied to the tree, possibly. Do you think they're tied to the tree? Okay, he's not,
yeah,
right?
Exactly.
Why do you think this little boy can be tied to a tree?
Well, because there's like a flood going on and the old man probably doesn't want him to fall or something sharper than might go inside him.
Okay, oh, that'd be terrible. No. That could be a fatal injury.
Yeah.
Isaiah, do you think there's a flood happening in this painting?
Maybe a flood, maybe a tsunami.
I can't hear you, honey.
Maybe a flood, maybe a tsunami.
Okay, maybe a flood or tsunami. Okay, and I know.
They hold on to it so they don't get swept away into deeper parts of like the island where they're being houses. Where they can drown.
Okay, so they're holding on to this palm tree literally for life, for their lives, because they don't want to get swept away by the water, correct? All right. I'm going to have Isaiah, if you would not mind, we're going to go to the back cover of our book. That's right. Turn to the back cover of our book. Mind, please turn to the back. Thank you. Isaiah, can you read in a loud voice for us an introduction of our book?
Okay. Philippe or Philip?
Sorry.
Philippe or
Philip.
Okay. Philip is excited when Germans invade the small island of Curacao.
Oh, Curacao.
Curacao. War has always been a game for him, and he's eager to glimpse it firsthand until the freighter he and his mother are traveling to the United States. He and his mother are traveling on to the United States. It is torpedoed. When Philip comes to, he is on a small raft in the middle of the sea beside two cats. His only companion is an old West Indian, Timothy Cook. Philip remembers his mother warning about black people. They are different, and they look differently. By the time the castaway arrives on the small island sleep setting, we have made him blind and dependent on Timothy. This is the story of their struggle to survive and of Philippe or Philip's effort to adjust to his blindness and to understand the defined lives and loving old man who is his companion.
Thank you very much, Isaiah. Students, when Isaiah was reading that out loud, that introduction, and when you were reading the introduction with him silently, did you visualize anything in your mind? Did you see something happening?
Yeah.
You didn't see much, Charlie? Okay. Did you imagine anything, Michael, happening?
Yeah. The
war. Okay. Why did you think about war?
Because it's
the army and the
small island.
Yes, a carousel, okay? Do you guys remember a period of time when the German people recently were at war? Kind of recently?
Yeah,
we mentioned it a few times. We talked about Germany, a very sad event that happened a while ago in Germany involving the Jewish people. The Holocaust, correct? And World War II, remember we mentioned that? Okay, we talked about that earlier this year. So this, we're going to go back to our map of the Caribbean. This, so far, where does our story take place so far? What island was mentioned? Yeah, Carousel. Going to have Michael, can you come up and find Carousel for us? It does have a strange spelling and a strange pronunciation. Carousel. You can look on the back of your book to see how it's spelled. Carousel. Guys, be prepared to help Michael if he can talk. So you might want to look for it too while you're sitting down. Carousel. So I'll give you a hint at the near the bottom of the screen, near the bottom of the Caribbean. Near the bottom of the map. These are all the Caribbean islands. Why? I'm going to have Tron, can you come up and help me find Carousel? It's near the bottom of the map.
I can't see it.
It's a very, very, very small island. I'll give you a hint. Very small island country. It's right above South America. That's another hint.
Found it.
He found it, yeah? Excellent. So, Curacao's above which country?
Venezuela.
Excellent. And Venezuela's in what continent?
South America.
Yes, excellent. Thank you, boys. You may sit down. I'm going to look at some photographs of Curacao under Google Image Search. Okay. Let's look at images of Curacao. Right? Amani, what do you see? See trees, okay. What else do you see in this photograph?
Beaches.
Beaches, right? A beautiful beach. Okay.
It looks like a boat floating.
Where? Oh, it is floating. Yes.
It's not.
You don't think this boat's not floating?
No, it's just a shadow. It's an illusion.
Oh, I think it's floating. And Isaiah, what do you see in this photograph?
A turtle.
Big turtle, right? So have you guys ever swam with turtles before?
No.
Would you like to one day?
No.
And. Let's go more to the city. What do we see here, Tom?
A few buildings.
A few buildings, right?
It's like a boardwalk.
That's what I want to
see. Let's also go to a map of Carousel.
Why are houses so colorful?
That's a good question. Why do you think the people of Carousel have beautiful homes? Brightly colored homes?
I don't think they're beautiful.
No, you don't think they're beautiful? Okay.
I think it looks weird.
You think it's strange? Okay.
It's
Well, why do you think their homes are so bright? Why do you think so?
I don't know, so they can stand out more, so they don't lose track of which house they have. I don't find it
okay. necessary. So people can find their homes easier? Okay.
It's like they all look, where I live, all the houses look exactly the same.
Okay. Let's do this. Can someone find the capital city of Carousel? Capital city.
I found it.
Can someone come up and tell us the name of it and point to it?
Wells, Molinstan, Tad.
Isaiah, come up, please.
Can
you please point to the capital city of Carousel? How would you read that?
Willemstad.
Yes, Willemstad. And Carousel and a lot of our other Caribbean islands are located in which sea? Try which sea?
Caribbean.
Let's give other people turn on it. I call it
Caribbean Sea.
Yes, the Caribbean Sea, okay. Excellent. All right. We have other cities like North Soto, Barber, Savannah, West Punt, etc. All right. In the K, our story of the K also takes place in other islands, such as U.S. Virgin Islands, Jamaica. Okay. Right now, I'm going to pass out some images to you about the Caribbean islands. They refer to the Caribbean islands, so I'll listen to more Caribbean music. Okay. We have here, everybody. Yes, chicken. Jerk chicken with grilled pineapples, lime. And dirty rice. Dirty rice just means seasoned in different colors like brown and yellow, okay? This is a very popular dish from Jamaica. When I went to Jamaica, I had jerk chicken. It's very good. This jerk chicken is also served with grilled pineapples and lime. You may look at that photograph and then pass it down.
I had that before. I think it's so bad, golden brown.
You farm pass, yes, golden trout is a lot of good stuff as well.
And like,
jerk chicken.
And I had like just, well, I had a golden trout.
That's 15.
Or something.
Mm-hmm.
Like sweet sour chicken, same. But the, kind of like, or something. It had like a, kind of like a lemon, kind of had like a lemon orange mixed with it, stuff like,
okay, so, alright. Alright. Guys, we're gonna learn what a K is. Let's. Imani, honey, look at it closely, okay? What do you see, Imani?
It's 15.
What island do you think this is? Okay, Caribbean Island, maybe the Bahamas. Okay, you can pass it down to Tehran. Guys, what do you think a K is? Why do you think this book's called the K? What do you think the K can be?
Kind of like
what
people go, like real nice things.
Okay. Alright. You said people go for what?
Where people go to have a vacation, have a retirement, where you see nice places and everything.
Okay. Amani, what do you think a K is? Okay, what does it mean? It means what? Okay, a K. She's actually kind of correct, guys. A K, everyone look up here, please, at this photograph. And this is an example of a K. A K can also be spelled C-A-Y-E or K-E-Y. So it could be pronounced K or K, I believe. A K is a small, low elevation, sandy island on the surface of a coral reef. So low elevation means it's not very mountainous, it's very flat land. On top of a coral reef. I will show you guys a coral reef. Have any of you ever seen this before? A beautiful coral reef, such as at the aquarium or the swimming pool?
I don't know.
You think about SpongeBob? Why don't you say SpongeBob, Michael?
It looks like there's just no pineapple.
I'm sorry, going too fast. Pineapples. Look at that.
What is that?
This is a healthy coral reef. I'm not sure where this is though. Where do you think this could be?
Jamaica?
Possibly, yes. When I was swimming snorkeling in Jamaica, I went about 13 feet underwater. I saw the most brightest neon fish, like neon pink, neon green, very bright fish. Mind you, pass it down, honey. Here's another example of a K. Turn your thumb to the hand, you can press it down. Thank you. Here's another Caribbean island. Come on, take that one from my hands. Why do you say that? That's a sailboat. So you're saying this is the scenery you see in SpongeBob?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
And also, that reminds me of what I have about the cat. I always
wonder if the arrows. Oh, about the Caribbean?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that's a good point. So Tron said he wonders what the Caribbean smells like. And you're actually jumping ahead for us in a good way.
Because I don't know what people think about it.
And we're going to get to that for our brainstorming activity. Yes. Pass that to Isaiah, please. Thank you. Monty, what do you think you would smell in the Caribbean? What kind of food?
Chicken.
Well, okay, excellent. You do love chicken as well, all right? Okay, guys, we're going to get started on our brainstorming activity. Please open up your writing journals to a new page for today. Please write today's date. Today is June 23rd, 2015. I'm going to pause the music for now. Do you guys like the music? Do you know what we call that music from Jamaica? I mean, there's many Caribbean islands, as you saw from our map. But do you know? Yes, what do we call that specific music from Jamaica? It starts with an R. Tron, do you know?
Nah.
Amani, do you know?
Yeah.
What is it called? It's called reggae. Reggae music. So people like Bob Marley, other famous musicians from Jamaica. It's on the board. June 23rd, 2015. Amani, go to the new page, please, honey. Giving everybody the whiteboards. Please place the whiteboards underneath your journals so you have a more sturdy surface to write on. You have a more sturdy surface to write on. Brainstorming activities where you do a lot of critical deep thinking on a keyword. Our word is island, okay? We can be today we're going to brainstorm mostly on Caribbean islands, okay? That's our focus because the K takes place in the Caribbean on an island called Curacao, all right? Please jot down some ideas. In fact, whatever that you guys help me type on this chart, you're going to copy in your journals, okay? We're using our five senses. Saran, can you read all the questions you see?
What can you see on an island? What can you hear on an island? What can you touch on an island? What can you taste on an island? And what can you feel on an island?
Thank you. Why do I have certain words highlighted in different colors?
Because they might be important.
Yes. Why are they important?
Well, because we need to know that what can you see, hear, touch, taste, and feel.
Amani, so these are called our five.
Five.
Excellent, our five senses. Beautiful. All right, so we'll start with Amani. Amani, if you went to a Caribbean island, what might you see?
Pineapple.
You'll see what?
Pineapple.
Pineapple's excellent, okay?
Wait, our touch and feel the same thing.
Yeah.
Okay.
So how about we do smell?
Yes, you're right. I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
Thank you for that. Guys, we're going to just jot down a few ideas. We're not going to do really long sentences right now. And again, the purpose of this lesson is to help give you an introductory lesson for the book you're going to be reading all summer long, the K. Okay? A nice introduction to this word. You'll be going to some activities tonight for home. Okay? You'll be ready for your summer reading of the book. So, Amani said pineapples. Guys, just drop down what you say. Pineapples. We'll do about four or five categories.
Trees.
Trees, thank you. What kind of trees?
Palm trees.
Can you give me a specific? Palm, okay, palm trees. Okay. Isaiah, what might you see in the Caribbean on an island? Coconuts, okay. Do any of you like coconut milk? Or,
I tried it once.
Coconut milk does have a strange taste to it, but when it's flavored with other ingredients, I like it.
Coconut chicken.
Oh, coconut chicken, that's good, so. And Michael, did you tell us what you would see on the island? Please write it down, guys, when you see the board.
Ocean.
Ocean? Okay. Guys, please actually make this chart as well. Make this copy of this chart to the best of your ability. We'll start in the other direction, start with Isaiah now. Well, actually, we'll pop on. Isaiah, what can you hear on island?
Birds.
Like, birds?
They have them, those birds that are deep, so like, they're in the food. It's really
hot. Oh, the toucan? You hear the toucan sing?
Yeah.
Okay.
Mainly found in top islands, right?
Yes. Also, that's like the Amazon rainforest. Amani, what can you hear about an island? You hear, what is the beach, what sounds is the beach making? What kind of noise? You hear music? Okay. Music playing on the beach. Michael, what might you hear on an island? Well, okay, waves crashing.
Yeah.
Sarah, what would you hear on an island?
not sure.
You're not sure? Okay. We'll come back to you, okay?
Maybe.
What is the air going?
No.
Whistling? Okay. Okay, the air moving?
Yeah, you can hear it slipping.
The wind?
You can hear it like brushing against the leaves too.
Oh, I like the wind brushing against the leaves. I love that. Palm leaves or plant leaves?
Yeah.
Beautiful. The wind brushing against plant leaves. That's a nice visual. All right, Amani. We're going to go to our next sense, guys, the sense of touch. What can you touch on the island? I didn't hear you. You touch the beach?
Yeah.
Amani, what do you touch on the beach? What can you touch when you go to the beach?
Tree.
You touch a tree? What kind of trees?
Green
trees?
Yeah.
What about palm trees?
Palm trees.
Okay, we do palm trees. Alright. Taran, what can you touch on? Sand, excellent. Michael, what about you? I make sure you're writing everything down. We already have that. I'm going to pay attention to what's on the chart so you don't repeat what's already been tagged up here. What can you touch on that? The water, excellent. Ocean water?
Yeah.
Okay. Jose, did you tell us what you can touch?
The fruits.
Okay. Any specific fruits?
They have kiwi, right?
I'm not sure. Some islands probably do.
Yeah.
I'll pick kiwi. Is that okay? Kiwi, I'll do kiwi and apples. Thank you, Michael.
Purple apples.
Purple, yes, in Jamaica. There are purple apples. Alright, here comes the fun part. What can we taste on an island?
Do islands have salty water?
That's a good question.
Every ocean
salty water.
That's a research question we have to look up there.
We already got palm trees.
Tara, what can you taste on an island?
Amani,
look at me. What else can you smell on an island?
A beach.
Okay, what do you smell at the beach?
Food.
What kind of food?
Chicken.
Okay, I think we have chicken already for what we taste. What else do you smell at the beach, Mom? Tell us something again. I can't hear you.
Pineapples?
Yeah. Okay. We'll go with pineapples.
She's doing a funny voice.
And Saran, would you tell us what you smell? Saran, sit up, please. What do you smell at the beach? I mean, at night, I'm sorry. Okay, you smell the vegetation, you smell the plants. The aroma, the odor of plants. Excellent, okay. At this point, I'm going to give you guys time to copy this chart, okay? So you have about 5 minutes to copy down this chart, all right? And after you copy down this chart, I'm going to begin telling you about the research project you have to do over the summertime in addition to reading your book, okay? Any questions on today's lesson so far?
No.
Okay.